In this presentation, we're going to cover patient preparation considerations for the barium enema exam, outline equipment and supplies needed to perform a BE, preparation of the exam room, enema tip insertion, and distinguish some differences in procedure between the single and double contrast enema. For patient prep, the large intestine must be completely emptied of all contents because retained fecal matter can simulate small masses or false positive readings radiographically. A restricted diet and bowel cleansing regimen are standard for healthy patients. Preparation for patients with severe diarrhea, gross bleeding, or obstruction is limited. Bowel cleansing methods include complete intestinal cleaning kits, GI lavage preparations, and/or a cleansing enema. BE apparatus consists of a disposable soft plastic enema tip and enema bags that are commercially available in different sizes. Smaller enema tips may be necessary for patients with strictures, fissures, inflamed hemorrhoids, or other anal abnormalities. Retention tips have a balloon cuff at the end. The balloon is manually inflated with air after insertion to aid in retention of the enema. For safety, the balloon is inflated using fluoroscopy just before the examination and should be supervised by a radiologist. There's potential for intestinal wall damage if inserted or inflated improperly. A special tip is required for double contrast to administer the air, which can be instilled via sphygmomanometer bulb. We'll be handling several types of enema tips, balloons, and other apparatus in the lab. Enema bags have 3-quart or 3,000 milliliter capacity, and a filter prevents passage of unmixed lumps of barium. The tubing is approximately 6 feet long with flow control clamp or clip. Smaller bags, around 500 milliliters, with short, larger diameter tubing are available for double contrast procedures. It's best to follow manufacturer's instructions for barium suspension preparation. High-density barium is used for double contrast. Temperature of suspension should be lower than the body temperature, between 85 and 90 degrees Fahrenheit. Otherwise, it can cause injury if too warm. Higher temperatures are also uncomfortable for the patient and decrease retention. Patient cooperation is key to success. Explain the patient's role and examination required. Instruct the patient on ways to minimize discomfort during filling, such as relaxing the abdomen, taking deep breaths, and communicate about cramping so that the filling may be slowed or stopped. It's essential to allay fears and embarrassment. Encourage retention of barium and allow questions and provide answers as within the scope of practice or refer to a physician. Make sure to provide adequate draping for increased patient comfort. Be aware of the patient's strength, condition, and age, and remember that the bowel prep may cause weakness. Elderly patients may require extra care and attention. Call the patient's attention to the call button in the restroom in case assistance is needed. Respect the patient's privacy, but inquire frequently on a patient's condition. Patient prep typically includes the following: a light evening meal prior to the exam, bowel cleansing cathartics, being NPO after midnight or 8 hours minimum, no gum chewing, no smoking, possibly an enema the morning of the exam. Several factors should also be considered for room preparation: fluoroscopy room setup, table horizontal, cassettes available, contrast media prepared, and towels and linens available. A single-use closed system kit is typically used. Make sure cold versus room temperature water is added. Mix well before use. Glucagon injection may be administered and is optional in case spasm occurs. Topical anesthetic may also be added to contrast media. Have your enema tip prepared. Special supplies for colostomy may be used. A colostomy post-operative kit and/or colostomy tip may be required when introducing contrast into an ostomy. This may be used in combination with a traditional kit, or it may be used independently. The protocol will vary per patient, and the radiologist should determine the routine for these specialized exams. For enema tip insertion, instruct the patient to turn onto the left side, roll them 35 to 40 degrees, and rest on flexed knee above and in front of the left knee. This is called the Sims position, and it relaxes the abdominal muscles, decreases abdominal pressure, and aids in relaxation of the anal sphincter. Adjust the IV pole height so that the bag is no higher than 24 inches or 61 centimeters above the level of the anus. Expose the anal region only. Run barium into the basin to remove air from tubing. Lubricate the enema tip and instruct the patient to take deep breaths. You're going to want to insert the tip slowly, steadily, and gently during expiration of deep breath. Direct the tip anteriorly, 1 to 1.5 inches, then slightly superiorly. The total distance, no more than 4 inches or 10 centimeters. Never force insertion. Ask the patient to assist if resistance is met and if the patient is capable. After the tip's inserted, hold it in place while the patient turns to the supine or prone position. The retention cuff may be inflated at this time. Free the tubing of compression to ensure free flow. For a single contrast BE, introduce the patient to the radiologist. When the radiologist requests, release the clip and allow the barium to flow. Flow is suspended periodically to reduce cramping and defecation impulse. Filling of the large intestine will be viewed on the fluoroscope. The technologist controls the rate of flow. Make sure you're pinching the tube to slow down the rate of flow if the barium travels outside the view of the fluoroscope. The tube can be opened again once the field of view pans to the region the contrast is leading. For single contrast studies, the radiologist instructs the patient to rotate to visualize all portions of the bowel and take spot radiographs as needed. Subsequent overhead radiographs will also be requested if needed. After all images acquired, remove the enema tip and allow as much of the barium as possible to drain back into the bag while the patient is on the exam table. Deflate the retention balloon and assist the patient to the restroom. Instruct them to expel as much barium as possible. Provide a bedpan for weakened patients who are unable to ambulate to the restroom. After the patient has evacuated, another radiograph is taken to check mucosa. If evacuation is inadequate, the patient may be given a hot beverage for stimulation. Repeat post-evacuation images as requested. There are two methods for double contrast enema, the closed system and the Whalen methods. The closed system method does not require removal and reinsertion of the enema tip. Barium is introduced and removed via bag position, and air is introduced by bag insertion or manual compression of the sphygmomanometer bulb. The patient remains on the table for the entire procedure. The Whalen method is recommended for early detection of small lesions. For this method, barium is introduced to the left colic flexure, and then the tip is removed and the patient evacuates. Then the tip is reinserted, barium is introduced to the sigmoid, and air is instilled. The patient's position is altered to coat the mucosa, and spot radiographs are taken as needed.